"What you drawing?" I asked playfully, flopping my head. you staying in David's house tonight? Nariah arched a brow at me. No, I blushed. His mom got us sleeping in the bed together. We weren't even doing anything. I was just tired of sleeping on a futon. I cleared my throat. Could I stay in She patted my hand and smiled. Don't worry, C. You always work something out. I was pretty good at talking my way into hearts and homes, but my charm had its limits. There had been more than a few nights I had to sleep on a park bench. Becca chucked a pizza roll at the window, and it landed with a sloppy clunk and slid onto the floor. Why can't we see anything through it? Shouldn't we be able to see, like, a cement wall or something behind it? It's like the light from the ceiling isn't going through the glass. So weird. It was definitely odd. I had pressed my face right up against the pane many times, trying to see what was on the other side. I could never see anything other than deep, velvety darkness. Toby tossed a second pizza roll at the window, slightly harder. When was the original school built? I mean, how long has that window been there? It was at that exact moment we heard a faint scraping sound, followed by a soft thud. The window pane slipped free of its hold to the wall and tumbled backwards into the dark. It landed with a resounding shatter on the other side of the empty windowsill. Nariah jumped to her feet. Oh my god. We waited to see if anyone would come to investigate the noise, but no one did. The four of us clustered around the missing window. Nariah was the first to stick her head in. Wow, I still can't see a thing. You can kind of see the floor where the glass is reflecting light, but I don't see another wall here. Just open darkness. The bell rang. Becca and Toby were already bored of the broken window. Becca yanked Toby towards the door. Bye guys, gotta bounce. If I'm late to track one more time, coach is gonna make me run extra laps. You guys should go too. That window hole isn't safe. There could be rats or snakes and stuff in there. She saluted me like a soldier. Sweating and breathing heavy. We have to go in there, see? I blinked at her in disbelief. Nah, I'm pretty sure we don't. In fact, I think it's a very bad idea. I reached for her hand, but she swatted at me in annoyance. See? Her eyes went wide. They might fix it by tomorrow, and then I'll never know. I'll never get to see what's on the other side. This is our only chance. Come on, skip fifth period and come on a little adventure with me. No, absolutely not. It's just gross old wall and construction stuff in there. And you even said yourself you can't see anything. We can't tell for sure. formal Wednesday routine. "Hey man, are you okay?" There was no response. Araya became very quiet and sat down in the desk directly behind the boy. "Hey kid, you shouldn't be here. It's not safe." I used my authoritative adult voice and placed a firm hand on his shoulders. "Come on, kid. How did you even get down here? Are you hurt? Are you hiding from someone? Look, Naraya, help me out here. Tell this kid he's gotta come with us." Naraya's eyes darted toward me with an imperceptible shift of her neck. "Shh," she replied. was the story. I'm so sorry for my super loud.